This is going to be a brief video showing what the QRP station is shaping up to be. So, of course, recently I got the uSDX transceiver from DL2MAN, Manuel, and PE1NNZ, Guido. Great device, and I'm very, very impressed with it. And we're going to use that right quick to simulate a CW setup here in the shack before taking this out in the field. Just a note, this is a homebrew power supply or battery pack that I've made. It's two sets of three 18650 batteries. It gives me 12 volts or right about there. And since I put them in parallel, that helps me out with the current draw situation. Over here, the iambic paddle is the N6ARA iambic paddle. And this one is $25, or it was when I bought it. It's a very good device. I've been very impressed with it. Notice in passing that I'm using these little fellows right here, these Velcro tie wraps. This was a great idea from one of the YouTubers that go on POTA activations. And I went ahead and bought some, and they are great for cable management. This over here, of course, is the power pole connector to the uSDX. And in passing, my station would comprise also these headphones. Now, it could be said that you could use earbuds, but for longer outings out in parks on the air or in the field, I find that these are just better sound suppression, sound insulation, and also more comfortable. So I go ahead and take these, even though they're quite big. If you think about this as a station to be very small, tightly packed. Okay, but we're not going to use that right now, so we'll put this off to the side. Similarly with, of course, our recording device, I use a pen, a felt tip pen over here, and a backup pencil in case that goes out. So I just record my logs without the use of a computer with this very portable pen and paper. And of course, probably the most, the most important part of any station, field or otherwise, is your antenna. In this case, I'm going to be using a NFET half-wave that is using the 49:1 transformer. I've got it strung out on the side of the home here, so that should help us out. So let's first go ahead and plug in our antenna. Next, undo the little tie wrap and figure that we're going to plug this into the key slot. And let's get rid of some of this cable off to the side. And then now we have our iambic gear. The next thing to do is to put in our power supply plug there. And of course, I've gone ahead and done it and made power pole connectors with it. So that makes it very universal. So I plug in my power. Just in passing, that's what I typically do at the last, as the last thing is to put energy to my system. In other words, to attach the energy source. It's just a safety feature or safety habit that I've gotten into. Okay, so now everything is plugged in. And the uSDX comes to life. And we see that it is at 14062. It's got my call sign. I was able to program that in. So that's working out pretty well. In passing, we notice that we are in CW. If we quickly click the Enter key, we switch mode to LSB. Quick Enter key, USB, and it goes back to CW. So we'll leave it in CW. Another mention is the options, which you access with the menu. They are grouped like in a chapter and subsection format, like in a table of contents, if you will. So you have the 1.something, 2.something, 3.something, 4.something, etc. for the options here in the menu. So the 1. options are very generic. The 2. options, which we're going to right now, are the CW options. So let's go into that. And as mentioned, we have the 2.1, which is the CW decoder. It's a very good decoder and it's on. This one is important, 2.4, semi-QSK. That needs to be off when you do FT8. And by the way, this little device can do FT8 without cables, without audio cables, just with a USB cable directly to your computer. May want to do a quick video about that at some other time. But for CW operations, semi-QSK is what I like. And then the key air speed is 2.5, which I've got at 15 words a minute. The keyer mode, this is where you would change to straight or iambic A or iambic B. I've set it to iambic A. And then keyer swap, not sure about that one, but 2.8 practice is very important. It's set to off right now, which means that right now the transceiver is live. He will transmit power outside of this BNC connector. So be aware that if you want to go ahead and use this as an oscillator to practice, you need to change that setting to off, from off to on. So on practice means you're just not transmitting anything. By the way, to change that, all you do is hit the menu key. You get the little greater than symbol now, and you just use the knob to switch from on to off. We're not gonna do that right now. So let's enter, and there we go. So now we're going to see if we can be heard. So we'll just use the QRL, and I'd like to point you out to the to the decoder. It's pretty good decoder there. Here we go. And of course, QRL is not what I just sent. I sent CRL. Let's try that again. So nobody's on the frequency. Let's call CQ a couple of times. Okay, let's try it again. Okay, we seem to have been heard right outside of Tucson, Arizona by KO7 Sierra Sierra. And those guys are 911 miles away from us. So that's pretty impressive. And they're hearing us with 7 decibel SNR, which is not the best, but it'll work. Let's do a couple of more calls, see if we're heard by anybody else. So I don't know if you noticed, but in the previous call out, I made a mistake. It was a little bit too much of a drawn out character or something to that effect. When that happens to you, my suggestion is keep on going. Don't stop, because the other side will understand that that was a flub and they're going to be listening close to you resending the information, which is what we did. So just resend the information, get your wits about you and resend the information and you'll be fine. Okay, so now notice that we have been heard by another station on the other side of the country, now by Whiskey 3 Oscar Alpha, which is 947 miles away, and they are over in, I believe, North Carolina. So we'll do a few more and call it a day. There may be a station there, but it is just too faint for me to hear. Okay, we're being heard in Chicago now. So as you can tell, this little device is working very nicely, and a QRP station would not be that complicated. As we mentioned, a recording system and some headphones for convenience and better signal to noise resolution by one's brain. So that's what I've got for today, the beginnings of a QRP station. Hope you found it interesting.